The Turkana Boy. Catchy, right? Who is he? In 1984, a team led by Richard Leakey, then of the National Museums of Kenya, and AlanWalker, an American colleague, discovered an almost complete skeleton in Nariokotome, west of Lake Turkana, Kenya. This fossil, which dated approximately 1.5 million years ago when studied, was found to belong to a boy between 11 to 13 years old and was also known as the fossil find of the century. Because it was so complete, it revealed a great deal not only about the anatomy of his species but of many others. Dating of this particular skeleton was easy because the Turkana boy lived in a region of active volcanoes whose deposits can be dated. This boy was named the Turkana boy due to the place it was found and is said to belong to the species Homo ergaster, or otherwise known as African Homo erectus. His age was revealed by the fact that his molar teeth were still emerging, yet he was already about 1.5 meters tall and would have been over 1.8 meters at maturity. His legs were relatively long in proportion to his body compared to earlier hominids like Lucy. From his build, it was safe to say that he was well adapted to staying cool in hot, dry climates. His ribcage and shoulder girdle indicates that he could swing his arms when walking or running, as we do, something the earlier hominids were incapable of. The anatomy of their hands strong his family have been carrying hunting tools like spears. Turkana boy revealed that his species walked more like us than older hominins did. He centered his weight over his pelvis as he walked, just like us. He also had arched feet and a relatively long stride. It is extraordinary in its completeness. Only a humerus and the ends of the hands and feet were missing. With a volume of about 880 cubic centimeters, his cranium was larger than an Australopithecine, but smaller than a modern human's. The Turkana boy and his kind represent the beginning of a new phase of human prehistory. They are evidence that the basic human body size and shape had evolved by 1.5 million years ago and probably as early as 1.9 million years ago. Brain size had expanded slightly by this time but was still significantly smaller than that of Homo sapiens. There is also some evidence that they shared information and worked in teams. The Turkana boy species also made and used stone tools. The tools known from 1.6 million years ago in the Turkana Basin included some stone cores and flakes, but also large cutting tools such as hand axes. Before I end the video, let us have a peek at the theories of how the boy died. Now, although he died young, his bones show that he did not die from an attack by a predator because his nearly complete skeleton shows no damage from either predators or scavengers. Instead, his jaw shows that he had a diseased gum where a deciduous molar teeth had been shed. An infection seems to have set in and he probably died of blood poisoning. One other thing researchers noticed about the boy was that his vertebrae, which forms the spine, were diseased, causing a subtle curvature and probably slow movement. This may also be another reason that might have contributed to his death. But a new analysis published in the American Journal of Physical Anthropology suggests that apart from a herniated disc in his back, Turkana boy was a fairly healthy person with no genetic bone problems. Therefore, the cause of his death is still not clear yet. With that, we have come to the end of the video. Thanks for watching, guys. Do drop in a comment telling us what you thought of the video and what content would you like to see next from us. For more related videos, check our channel out and do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella, and see you in our next video.